Welcome to Creamer Media's Resources Watch, a weekly video roundup of the events and people making and shaping the news in the mining industry. This week, a massive operational makeover is underway at AngloGold Ashanti. Iron ore miner Kumba determinedly keeps its foot on the production and project accelerator throughout the economic meltdown period. And we attend Impala Platinum's latest presentation to gain new insight. AngloGold Ashanti is virtually changing the way it does every basic activity in the business.
We are then re-engineering our operating processes, and by re-engineering I mean changing the way we almost do every basic activity in the business.
The idea and the model we're working on is change the way we plan and schedule the work and how we interface and manage people through the organisation, and we really are talking about through transformation. And so for us, we believe that in that process alone there's a 20 to 30% improvement to be had in terms of output per person. It really is a combination of leadership, work practices and the way we support people doing the work, and some incremental technology changes. So all of those things have to come together for us to take at least 20% out of our cost structures, and that's where we're focused, that's where we have to go. In fact, that's where we all have to go in this industry.
Strongly producing South African iron ore miner Kumba will be increasing its capital expenditure in 2010 to between 4.5 and 5 billion rand.
We will be increasing capital as we increase our spend on Sishen South on the Kolomela mine. So we're giving a range today between 4.5 and 5 billion rands worth of capital spend for 2010. So we will be increasing our project spend, and we will be increasing our spend on staying business capital as we need to increase the amount of waste mined. We had a great cost performance this year. In real terms, we were able to decrease costs, notwithstanding 18 million ton increase in waste mined at the mine. So we increased waste by 28% on the mine. This is part of the plan. It's very necessary to secure the future of the mine. So we again delivered on our promises, but this had a big cost impact. But notwithstanding that big cost impact, we were able to offset that because of the benefit of the volume.
The platinum price collapsed along with the automotive market early last year, but a much-changed outlook is now lifting sentiment.
The recovery in the platinum market has emphasized once again that the world's economic power has shifted east. Impala Platinum's Derek Engelbrecht reports.
The dismal automotive market, as well as the significant deleveraging by investors of commodities across the board, saw platinum prices drop from north of $2,000 down to a low of something like 750. You can be sure at the 750 level, some of our retirement dates were being studied very closely. But we held on. Prices started to recover. We are now at levels pre the Eskom crisis. The whole economic power has shifted east. Order sales have been nothing short of astonishing in this market, and it's now the biggest market in the world, having overtaken the USA in 2009.
More cars were sold in China in just the month of January than for the entire year of 2002.
It's still clearly too early to start annualizing this number, but if one did, it points to a 15 to 16 million vehicle market, which would match, you know, the USA in its kind of heyday.
Not to be sneezed at either are India's car sales.
India last year sold in excess of 2 million vehicles, and now rank only behind Germany and exceed all other European markets in terms of sales.
Motorcycle demand is now also entering the fray to boost platinum.
For both China and India, motorcycle production of almost 30 million units now require the fitment of catalytic converters.
Also presenting strong demand are the platinum exchange traded funds, or ETFs.
The impact of the launch of the US-based ETF in platinum and palladium has been significant. It took the Europeans 1 year to reach these levels, which the Americans have achieved in 1 month.
And then there's also jewelry, where the appetite for platinum has seemingly not abated.
For mining news as it breaks, stay logged on to miningweekly.com and register for our free daily newsletter.